In this video, I'm going to share with you one of the plugins that I found from the Rhino3D.com, and it's really useful to have all different kind of facets to play with. Are you ready? Let's get started. The plugin, and it's free, that I'm going to share with you is the one right here on the top. It's called Polyhedra. And this is command is I download from the Rhino 3D. Let's go ahead with the Google and find where that software and plugin is. If you go to Rhino3D.com and then you go into resource, there are a lot of very interesting things here. Some is useful, some will charge you. A lot of them are free. You can find more of those kind of plugin in the food for Rhino as well. And if you go to Jewelry, it actually has a lot of about 3D printing, different kind of resource for you. What I wanted to find and already found it, it's called Polyhedra, and it's for Rhino 6, and what all you need to do is download this one, and it's totally free. Once you download and you go to your Rhino, then what you need to, how you're going to bring up is going to toolbar command, and in your toolbar command you will see something right here for all your plugin. I have paneling tool, I have the default for which you have as well, and then you will have this Rhino Polyhedra. Once you click on the Rhino Polyhedra and this little things, it's usually it will show up anywhere like this little window right here, and you just need to tuck in into any place that you like. Somebody like it on the bottom, so I like it on the top. What are they is they can create those mesh really really quick, and you have a lot of options. So that's just gonna go in, open the window, and I'm not a mathematic or scientist person, so a lot of them I don't even know what they are, but luckily is they always have preview, right? So you can open any of them and look at the preview and see if that works for you. So what we're gonna do with this is we're gonna pick up the shape for the jewelry purpose. We're gonna pick up the shape that we think we will like. I will say this is very good for few purpose. First, you can use for some crystal. Instead of building all this crystal yourself, you can use this and tweak it with it. Or you can create some sort of a facet jewelry with this and bowling them all together. Okay, so I already have some foam that I pick it up over here, and I'm gonna use one of them, maybe this one, to create a ring really quick. So let me copy that into other layer here and turn off this. All right, so this is what we have, and remember this is going to be mesh. Okay, if you click on this, it will say close mesh. So we have to use the mesh editing tool. Something really quickly, I'm going to use the align tool and align to the center. So that is right in the middle. The same thing on the top, align to the center. So actually the center is at zero at this point. You can rotate in any angle you like. I'm just gonna do a quick demo here. Let's go ahead to set the ring size to diameter 16 millimeter over here, and I do want my ring actually much bigger, something like this. Okay, and I'm gonna look at the top view to decide how thick I wanted to have my ring. So for example, something like this. So I'm gonna use the gumball 1D scale it down, and we are going to create a extrusion. So I'm going to use the extruded planar curve, both sides equal yes. All right, notice that the one I just extruded right here say is closed extrusion, and this one is mesh. Those two cannot be added at the same time. So we need to turn this one into the mesh first. So right here, click on that triangle, you will have mesh tool. Well, what we wanted to do is we want to turn it into the mesh, And usually I will just use this one has either fewer polygon or more polygon. If you are really into the certain type of the mesh, you might want to come in more detail to adjust it. I'm just going to stay with the more polygon and click OK. So regular bowling tool is not going to work because those are working for poly surface or nerve surface. We need to have this mesh tool. Under the mesh tool, you have this bowling mesh unit, bowling mesh difference. So we're gonna use mesh bowling difference. This will be difference out of this one. Let's take a look on the render view. As you can see, this is a pretty good mesh. We might not able to round the corner at this point, but we can have your jeweler after casting just running off the corner a little bit, and this is ready to go. You see, just few minutes, then you will get a pretty good facet ring over here. The second things that we can do, I'm just quickly come up something really rough here. This is a look at a bunch of bubbles stick together, but they all have facet. And let's take a look on the render view. So once they finish, they will look like something like this. To get in this point is quite easy too. Basically, what I did is I pick up one of the rough surface and bowling union, mesh bowling union them together and cut a ring out of it. So they are a lot of useful plugging and a lot of them are free at Full for Rhino. I hope you enjoy today's video and try out something to show me what you get. I would love to see what you come up with. If you are the first time to my channel, don't forget to subscribe it. And if you feel this is a fun channel, you like to have more video, please like it and comment. So that way it will help me to create more video. Thank you for watching. I will see you next.